Children are full of curiosity and wonder about every little thing around them. But somewhere along the line, a lot of us lose that childlike curiosity. Old people know the answers, so we're just not as curious as we used to be. At least that's the conventional wisdom, and there are some studies that support it. But there's also some recent research that suggests older people may be more curious than their younger counterparts, and that may help you maintain your brain as you age. Naturally, scientists are curious about the reasons for those mixed results. As it turns out, we may have been thinking about curiosity all wrong. As you age, your priorities change. While you used to be motivated by the adrenaline of meeting new people and trying out a new bar, these days you're more satisfied by a comfortable night in and a solid amount of sleep. It seems that you are focused on different things later in adulthood than you used to be, and that is supported by research. Studies have shown decreases in curiosity about other people, yourself, and new knowledge from early to late adulthood, plus less openness to new experiences. And for years, researchers have been trying to figure out why. One hypothesis hinges on the idea that when you are younger, you have a lot of time left before you die. So earlier in life, you prioritize seeking out new information and experiences that could prepare you for whatever might come up in those intervening years. Then, as an older adult, you recognize that your time is limited. So you prioritize what you are confident will make you happy, and you avoid unfamiliar situations. Another hypothesis is more about how your brain ages. When you explore new things that pique your curiosity, your neurons release more dopamine. But as you age, your dopamine levels might start to decline. Not only that, but they also have fewer places to bind, and generally aren't as responsive to new things as they used to be. All that evidence fits together to tell a simple story. You use dopamine when you're curious, and your body's response to that chemical, along with curiosity, decreases with age. But things are never that easily explained, especially with the brain, because you might not have a complete decrease in curiosity as you get older. For example, more than 1 million people were surveyed to see where they land across the big five personality traits: openness to experience, conscientiousness, extroversion, agreeableness, and neuroticism. And the researchers who conducted that survey concluded that older people are more open to seek out new experiences. Which is great news, because curiosity is really beneficial. It can help you connect with people, boost your memory, and is associated with greater physical and mental well-being. It might even be associated with staying sharp in old age. A small study from 2006 tested this among healthy 65 to 85-year-olds. They were all given images on a computer screen to look at, and participants who spent more time looking at new images performed better on cognitive tasks than those who paid more attention to the stuff they'd seen before. So scientists think that there is a correlation between being curious and maintaining your youthful brain power. This might all come back to those brain chemicals. Many areas of the brain that stop working as well when you go through dementia are in charge of stuff that's important for curiosity, like learning, memory, and reward. And get this, you'll also find dopamine there. So as you age, you might have less dopamine functionality, you might have dementia-related damage to the parts of the brain where dopamine goes, and you may be less curious. But that doesn't line up with the other research suggesting that older people are more open to new experiences. A study published in 2025 helps to clear this all up. But before I go into details about all of that, I got a quick ad that I need to show you.
This SciShow video is supported by Jump, the statistical analysis software trusted by the largest pharmaceutical companies, consumer products companies, and semiconductor companies in the world. Jump helps them manage unwieldy variables, improve scientific reproducibility, and gain insight into their data. So many big companies trust Jump with their giant datasets because it works through the whole data analysis process. You can access your data from various sources, apply powerful statistics, and use interactive visualization to share your discoveries, all on the same platform. If you're a young professional who's taking it to the next level above being proficient in Excel, you can visit jmp.com/scishow to reap the benefits of visual statistics for yourself and get a 30-day free trial.
Most of the studies I've mentioned so far in this video were snapshots of a single point in a lot of people's lives. Researchers look at that data and they draw conclusions about the average person. It's hard to do like a short-term study on a topic like aging that is a thing that takes a long time. You can end up in a chicken or egg situation where you don't have the evidence to know if being more curious is protective against cognitive decline or if having less cognitive decline lets someone maintain their curiosity. And that is where longitudinal studies come in. Those are studies that take place over a longer period of time, usually throughout years of the participants' lives. One longitudinal study published in 2013 found that retirees who sought out more cognitively challenging activities improved their scores in a test of memory, attention, language, and other cognitive functions from 1 year to the next. So if you're more curious, it is associated with improving your brain function. And a different four-year longitudinal study investigated associations with being less curious as you age. The researchers asked caregivers of people diagnosed with Alzheimer's disease if they showed signs of apathy, meaning they just weren't interested in stuff. Patients who were described as more apathetic over time experienced more cognitive decline than their peers. Now, this doesn't mean that curiosity specifically is protecting against cognitive decline, but it does mean that how curious you are can at least partially predict decline. And that's good to know, but it still doesn't clear up why some research suggests you get more curious with age and other studies say less. Part of the discrepancy in research findings may be due to different researchers measuring different things. After all, there's more than one kind of curiosity. A behavior can be state curiosity, if it's happening right now in response to something you find interesting, versus trait curiosity, if it's more consistently a part of you. Trait curiosity is subscribing to a YouTube channel and watching all the cool SciShow videos that come out Monday through Friday every week. State curiosity is scrolling past a video about curiosity and aging and wondering what the link between those two is and watching said video to find out. This trait versus state curiosity was investigated as it relates to aging in a 2025 study. To measure trait curiosity, they prompted participants with statements like, "I spend hours on a problem because I can't rest without the answer." And for state curiosity, they asked how curious people were to find out the answer to trivia questions, like what was the first nation to give women the right to vote. The researchers found that for older participants, trait curiosity, also known as their general tendency to seek out information, decreased. But their state curiosity, or interest in the answers to something specific, was higher for older participants. This may be related to that tendency of older people to focus their time and attention on things they are confident will be a good use of their time. You're no longer as curious about everything, but you're more curious about the things that are relevant to your interests and stuff you already engage with. That's why the History Channel does so well. Like, your grandpa might not want to learn a bunch of new skills and hobbies in retirement, but he may subscribe to a woodworking magazine, read woodworking books, watch woodworking YouTube videos, and practice new techniques for his little carved owl figurines. And honestly, he sounds like a hoot, so you are not doomed to live a less curious life in your final decades. In fact, your state curiosity might still be peaked when you hear about trivia questions like the one I mentioned from that 2025 study. And I'll save you from having to look it up, unless you did already, which we did in the studio immediately. The first country to give women the right to vote was New Zealand. Congrats to all the Kiwis. 1893. That's wild.